Hello, hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's a girl Ritual, your favorite finance lady. Like, I'm back, like, I never left, guys. Okay, so today I'm going to talk about different reasons why small businesses fail. Get feedback from customers. Some people fail to get feedback from customers. Feedback can be good or bad. So if you get a good feedback from customers and from your customer, you should know that you are doing something good, right? But there are rooms for improvement, trust me. But if you get a bad review from a customer, maybe your customer say, I don't like your services or I don't like your product, you need to work on it. That's what it means. You don't have to get angry or feel that, oh, this customer is trying to spoil my business. No, try to get feedback. Yes, I know that it's not all bad feedback that are really bad, really, but you know, still try to, you know, strategize, have an open mind, you know, and say that, okay, whether good or bad, you just need to work on it. You need to know what your customer wants, because you can't just keep assuming that, okay, this is what they want. You know, talk to them, let them know what they want, get feedback. It's really important and it's going to help your business. But if you're not doing this, if you're not getting feedback from customers, it can actually make your business fail, seriously. Another reason why small businesses fail is lack of marketing plan. You don't just start a business without marketing it. Like, if you start a business, you're the only one that know about the business. But if you market the business, talk to somebody about the business, so you can start extending to your family, your friends, and the likes. And when you are marketing your business, know where your target market is, know where your customers are. If you are providing services for maybe children, you need to advertise where maybe kids are or where their parents are. If you are selling goods that for teenagers, you need to advertise where teenagers are. So don't just say that because everybody's advertising on a particular platform, you go and advertise in that platform. If your customers are not there, trust me, nobody will know about your business. So learn to advertise where your customers are, and there are different marketing platforms online, social media, you know, different things. But if you notice nowadays, a lot of people advertise on social media, trust me. Even big companies, like, they feel some of their target markets, especially the youth, they don't really watch TVs. Most people are on their phones, they're on social media, you know, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and the likes. And if you notice, all these whole platforms have adverts on it, even YouTube, guys. Even vlogs, normal vlogs that you read have adverts on it, so they know that is where they're gonna get their target customers. So advertise where your target customers are. If you know you want to go into, you know, digital marketing, you want to go into marketing on social media and online, know that is where your customers are, and advertise very well. Tell people about your business. If you don't advertise, nobody will know your business, nobody will buy anything from you, and your business will just die. So marketing, advertising, this is like the heart of your business. It keeps the business running, guys. So take notes. Another reason why small businesses fail is stop following the crowd. Guys, like, do your thing, be different. So just because I'm starting a business, that's okay, the business have actually existed, a lot of people are into the business, doesn't mean that you follow their footsteps. Don't follow exactly what they are doing. Don't say because they're advertising in social platform, I should do this, or this is the amount they're selling, or this is how they are doing it. No, differentiation make your business stand out. Sit down and tell yourself, what am I going to do differently? Okay, so I am selling hair, and we have millions of people out there that are selling hair. What am I going to do differently? What am I going to give my customers? How am I going to present my business? It is important to be different. Be different, stand out in the crowd. When you stand in the crowd, your business names, you know, booms, comes out. But when you begin to follow the crowd and follow every footstep they make, guys, you will just be there like, follow. But when you stand out, you have a business strategy, you have a plan, you know, everything is on point, trust me, guys, your business is gonna grow. So before I go further, please click the subscribe button. The subscribe button is in red. Yes, click it, I'm waiting for you. Yes, so after clicking it, click on the, you know, the like button. Like my video. Like, how can I give you this nice tip without liking? Please like my video. Yeah, thank you. So get it next. Early celebration can make your business fail. Okay, so this is what I'm trying to say. A lot of people, a lot of small business owners celebrate too early. Just because you started your business and in next few months you are making cool cash, you're making a lot of profits, let me just say abnormal profits, like a whole lot of profit, and you're so overwhelmed and you're so happy, and you take that profit and begin to, you know, you change your car, you change your apartment, basically you just started buying things, personal things, things that are not even really necessary. So when you celebrate too early, you've forgotten that the business is still growing. The grain is a growing concern. You know, it's still going. And along the line, you will need to pump more money into the business. And when you get to that stage, you'll now be stuck like, oh, you don't have any money. Why? Because you celebrated too early. Don't celebrate too early, guys. Relax. Be patient. Yes, you've made profit. It's a good thing, seriously. But you need to pump the money back into the business. You need to put the money back into the business. It's very important because you have a long time to go. Like, your business have not really even survived the fragile period. Or even if it has survived the fragile period, you know, even if you want to do something for yourself, fine. But not taking all your money and celebrating and, you know, changing, buying things that are not necessary. You get, just try to pump the money back into the business. Relax, take your time. Fine, you've done well, you know, you've hit the jackpot and everything, but just take your time and, you know, try to pump the money back into your business. Let your business keep growing, because I am sure you want your business to be, you know, very large and big, you know, along the line. So relax. If you've watched this video this far, thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe, please. Click on the subscribe button, give the video a thumbs up if you like it, and if you've already subscribed to my channel, nice one, please share this video with your friends and keep watching. I'm about to drop my last point. So the last reason why small businesses fail is lack of business knowledge. I know most of us, a lot of people spend 5 years, 6 years, 10 years to study a particular course in the university, and after university you end up, you just throw that certificate away, you don't use it. Guys, this same thing applies to businesses. You need to understand the business. If I want to go into electronic business, I want to learn how to sell electronics, I need to study it. I need to know the market. I need to know how it goes. I need to know how I will get my goods. So basically, study your business. You need to have a knowledge of your business. See, that is why I like my Igbo people, my fellow Igbo people. So Igbo is the eastern part of Nigeria. So what are the Igbo men do is, so they just go learn trade. So if they are into maybe let's say selling electronics, they will go learn the trade for years, can be 2 years, 3 years, you know, and the likes, and they will graduate and they will open their own store. So basically they've understand the business. So it's not just, you know, going to a business and just starting a business or waking up in the morning and saying, you know what, this is the business I want to go into. Study the business, know the business, have a good knowledge about what you are going into. Know your competitors also. You can't just start a business of selling hair and you won't know your competitors, you won't know what other people are doing. So basically, studying the business, also study the environment of the business, economic, you know, political, all those small things. So basically, just having a good business knowledge and of what you're about to start, it's important. Some people don't have business knowledge, and that is why their business fail. So guys, so this is the final tip. If you've come this far, like I said before, thank you so much. You guys are amazing. Thank you for watching my video up to this point. I know you subscribed already, so thank you for subscribing. Thank you for giving it a thumbs up. You guys are amazing. I'm gonna see you in my next video, guys. Peace.